Derek, TonyVarsitySportsNetwork.com. We're here at St. Francis Academy, where Jerome Shelton is about to start season 29 as the head man for the Lady Panthers basketball team. Their season opener is a few days away against Capital Christian. Last season, St. Francis went 24-4, won their fourth straight IAMA Conference Championship, and they will try to make it five in a row in February, but we are a long way from February as he is getting his troops ready for the season. Coach, let's talk about the first few weeks of practice.
First few weeks, just balls everywhere. We're trying to, we integrate some new players into our system, so they're learning. We have good leadership on this team. Kalia Turner and Angel Reese and Anaya Gordine. They've been through the wars, so that kind of regressive leadership has allowed, regenerative leadership, pardon me, has allowed us to kind of blend the new players in a lot faster than I thought.
Mm-hmm.
But they're learning, they're growing every practice, and we talked about early in our preseason meeting how we wanted to weaponize our chemistry. We wanted to make sure that we understood roles. And that we don't develop an attitude of complacency or entitlement. So, again, we are proud of what we accomplished, but again, that's history for us. We're setting our sights on playing well this year.
Right. Well, some of the veteran leaders on this team. First off, talk about Angel Reese and mm-hmm. last superlatives when it comes to that young lady.
Yes. I tell you, it's been a four quick years with Angel. And the things that she's accomplished so far. And just being on national television as a freshman, I always think about that, scoring 20 points and getting 24 rebounds as a freshman. And I think it's been a trajectory that's gone higher and higher every year. She's gotten better every year. And I told her right now, as I mentioned to you last year, I think just understanding the game more, to winning the mental battles and understanding what other teams are trying to do to take you out of, the game plan is where we need to be now. So she's learned to do that. She understands now. She has, in my opinion, players around her that can take some pressure off of her this year. And so when those moments come, when she may get a double team or possibly a triple team, we have players now that we feel can step up and make plays.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And one of those players is Anaya Gordine, who came up big last year in the mm-hmm. championship game. Talk about just the progress that she's made the last 3 years.
Well, Anaya has gotten better every year as well. She's on the ball tough, and that's where it begins with her. She takes a lot of pride in her defense. Her leadership ability has grown, and I think part of that, I attribute some of that to Ron James this summer playing with Team Takeover and playing with Angel, and that team that won was the EYBL National Championship, and Anaya was the starting point guard on that team, so she had good talent all around her. She learned how to manage and perform at that level with very high level players. So I think that helped her, built her confidence up some more. And I think her ability to score, she's really a combo guard. She loves to pass the ball, but she can score. And she's a good teammate. So mm-hmm. we're looking forward to her exhibiting a lot of those skills that she showed over the summer, particularly in playing with poise under pressure like she did all summer in that EYBL tournament.
And Kalia Turner, she's going to go mm-hmm. to Bowie State. Talk about her.
Kalia as well. Mm-hmm. Kalia's a kind of player that is multidimensional, can play some point guard, play off the ball. We know she's a good on-ball defender, good teammate, sacrifices for the team. We like for her to increase her scoring output this year because we know she's capable. I think last year was a maiden voyage for her where she was fitting in, didn't look for a shot as much. Opportunities came for her to score. She did do that. But we're looking for her to take a little bit more of an assertive position in terms of scoring points this year.
Right. And just talk a little bit about some of the young kids you're excited about mm-hmm. or some returning players you're looking forward to seeing this year.
Diamani Dorsey has come along over the summer playing with a lot of confidence, shooting the ball with confidence, as well as Corey Barnes.
Mm-hmm.
Both of those players last year played key roles in our drive for our fourth championship. And I think learning how to play with good players and making that adjustment to girls varsity basketball, the size, the speed, the physicality of it, they look a lot more comfortable now. I would also include in that DK Turner, who I think has really improved over the summer, has come back from some injuries, but has shown me so far in our first two scrimmages that she's really going to make a difference and an impact. And certainly Zion Reynolds and Keontae Lewis, two players that I think will make an immediate impact. Zion is in the post at 6'3". And can score with her back to the basket and handle the ball and pass. And so she's a multi-dimensional a post player, which I really like. And Keontae Lewis reminds me a lot of Deanna Harmon, just a player who defended, who rebounded, who scored points, who took charges. She is really in that mold. And so those two players right there are going to really make an immediate impact.
How do you think this team on paper or what you've seen through – practices and scrimmages could be better than last year's team?
In terms of depth. In terms of depth. I think the quality of depth that we have this year is going to make a big difference. I think principally last year we only had two scores. You know, Anaya and Angel would score, and then we'd kind of get, you know, some scoring from other players. But I think this year our scoring output, we were only averaging 50 points a game, which is low for us. And so that was one of the first things I addressed in our preseason meeting, is that, you know, we want to score much more this year. And I think we have the depth to do it. I want to play at a faster pace. I'm excited about Cameron Dorsey coming in as a backup point guard right now for Naya Gordine as she learns our system, because she's really an energizer, likes to play the way I like to play, get the ball up and down the court and create scoring opportunities in transition, and is an excellent passer as well and can score. So that fits right into what we want to do, the design of how we want to play this year.
Well, talk about the schedule, Coach. You open up in a couple of days against Capital Christian. I know you guys go back to the John Wall Invitational in North Carolina, Blue Star, I think the She got game.
Right.
I mean, just talk about that non-league schedule. Again, very daunting.
Yes, well, that's how we like it. We have the players for it. In our program, I tell the players all the time, that's why you came here, because you wanted to play this kind of challenging schedule. We have a lot of 50-50 games on the schedule, and I think that's good for us. Going to She Got Game, we're playing, I think, Highland High School out of Florida, a very top-ranked Florida team. Going to John Wall, playing against three very good North Carolina teams. Playing against Riverdale Baptist in the DMV Super Games, and of course going to Stand Against Violence Showcase. We're playing against Oakland Catholic, which traditionally is a Western Pennsylvania power, and we have, I think, Imhotep Charter there as well. And then also Poly in the William Wells Classic. So that is what I like. I like that. I think that as a coach, I like it. I like to coach in those kind of games. 50-50 games to me are where you really, your teams are made. And I think that gives us an opportunity to see really the growth of our younger players in those kind of situations. They played in competitive situations all summer, and we want to continue that when they come here. We don't want to drop off in the level of talent that they have to compete against.
And of course, all these great non-league challenges get you ready for the IMA conference. And just talk about that again. It's going to be a murderer's row. You got McDonough, yes. You got Roland Park, right. Pilates, John Carroll is going to be tough.
Yes.
IND, I mean, just kind of talk about that league.
Well, it'll be like it always is. I think when you go in, first off, the quality of coaching is very good. And the coaches know our tendencies. They know what we like to do. And so that keeps the games close, the familiarity of the programs. I think you can start right there and the adjustments that coaches make to what we do and how they prepare for us. But again, non-conference games are just that. Conference games are going to be close because they know tendencies. So McDonough's going to be tough. You know, Roland Park is going to be tough. Mira McLean, I'm expecting her to have a very good senior year, along with Rain Green, who missed a portion of last year. Pilates got a whole lot better in terms of some of the kids that they bought in this year. So it's going to be exciting. I mean, I look forward to it. And nothing's ever easy in this conference. And that's how we like it.
Coach, last question. Three keys to success in 2019.
Well, first thing I would say is, you know, our theme this year is to stay elevated. Mm-hmm. And we chose that theme because, you know, we know people are coming after us, and it's important for us to stay with this team, stay in ourselves, don't beat ourselves, and I think don't have a sense of entitlement, and everybody understand their roles and come in and contribute.
All right, year 29 for Jerome Shelton over in East Baltimore as his Lady Panthers of St. Francis Academy getting ready for their season opener in a couple of days. They will again try to win the IMA Conference Championship and again hold on to number one in the Varsity Sports Network Top 20 as they will again start the season at number one. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Tony.